host back on the Boss Man Show. You see her getting her hair together right there. It's Juicy the Creative Mogul as her hair blends in with the background, the ambiance of the, I guess, sundress or whatever that is she has. So filling in with it, everything. Juicy, what's up?
Hello, how you doing? Hello, hi everybody.
No doubt, everything's everything. Tell me this, how is it up in New York with the weather? It's August, is it hot, humid? What is it up there, up in those parts of the world?
The weather right now, it's going in between like rain and it's hot and the summer seems here, it seems like it's almost literally over.
No doubt, I feel that. Well, it's like in the low 80s here in Atlanta and humid. So, It's rare for here. It used to be in the 90s, almost 100, choking you when you go outside. So, I'll say 80s and humid, well over 900 degrees and humid. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
No doubt. Well, Juicy, tell us about, give us a little bit about yourself and we'll ask more questions about you. So tell us how you got your name, Juicy. What do you do for a living? What is your businesses? And how can people get in contact with you and see you do what you do?
Yes. So my name is Juicy. I'm the creative mogul. I'm an author, model, actress. I'm pretty much a entrepreneur. My Instagram is juicy_the_publish_author. My book that I written myself is called Wait, How Do I? The Beginner's Guide to Makeup by Juicy. That's me. It is currently on Amazon right now. So if you get over to Amazon and you type that title in there, I am right there.
No doubt. Well, tell me this. You said you're an author, a model, you got love for makeup. What spurred those things in you to be interested in those things and to make them your career?
Being a creative person, my entire life, I've been always creative. So everything just clicked. It makes sense of my personality, how I am. And modeling, we had our makeup done. We wore different clothes. We had different hairstyles. So everything kind of like it all made sense.
No doubt. So what's your favorite thing about being a model? Like, is it the runway? Is it the makeup? Is it the outfits? I know that a lot of it goes into that. What's your favorite part of being a model?
The outfits and the different hair and transforming from different stages, I guess you would say, different themes.
No doubt. I feel that, like, you know, where have you modeled it? Have you ever done the Fashion Week in New York as far as modeling, or you behind, kind of behind the scenes? So what's been your favorite events to kind of get your model on, per se?
When I first started to do modeling, I worked with Koto Moto. She's a fashion designer for Project Runway in New York many, many years ago. And from there, I went to different kind of networking events, Fashion Week, they had some VIP events, some regular local events I went into, and just pretty much networked, like.
No doubt. Well, tell me this, Juicy. Like, yes. I've seen that you've been on MTV.
Yes.
MTV and other films. Tell our listeners about your MTV run and other films you've been in and how do those come about?
Networking, all about who you know. When I had did MTV, that was like 2009, and that was way before Love & Hip Hop, way before Basketball Wives, way before a lot of shows that we know now. And it was really uncut. It was like really reality. Like, it was no scripts. They were not telling us to fight anyone. They were not, you know, renting out stuff for us to pretend we are, you know. It was just really uncut.
Yeah, like, you know, Love & Hip Hop Atlanta, like, I get the emails to come be extra. Hey, you want to come be extra at this scene we're shooting today? Like I said about time, if they're telling you they're shooting today, that's code for it's scripted, people. Okay. Like, You ain't got four women or this many men meeting up at this one spot at this one day randomly on the same show. It's no coincidence. Yeah. It's no coincidence, people.
Yeah. It's scripted. No shade. I don't have no shade. But, you know, it's nice. I like the way how reality has changed. Like, you go through different, it's more like living the life of the person. Like, you, if it's an artist, you see them going into the studio, or if they're an entrepreneur, you see them building their business. So it's like the way from reality back then to now, it has changed. Yes, it's scripted, but, you know, I mean, I ain't knocking it. It's just to keep the audience entertained.
But some of the script writing is bad, though. Some of it's bad. Like, I'm watching, I'm like, this is some bad acting and bad scripting. So I'm like, wow, okay, this is hard to watch. Like, what's fun? No, what's funny, from being in Atlanta, I know when a lot of this stuff already happened, when it happened, right?
He was there.
Yeah, like, you know, so I'm like, that ain't how it really happened, but okay.
Right.
So see, that's the part that I be looking at. I'm like, I was around. Hey, that ain't how it really happened, but I see how y'all ended up, though. I see you working. Right. Yes. Right. So tell us about, right, you got a book. You wrote a book. It's on Amazon. Tell us about your book and what inspired you to write that book.
Well, I always will say I'm all about uplifting people and encouraging people to do what they like to do. So when I wrote the book and getting into makeup at the same time, it was like I didn't know certain things. You know, makeup is an artistry. So certain things we just do it ourselves. We just discover it ourselves. So I was like, you know what, why not write a guide about how to do makeup, or tell other women and guys about what to do. What is an eyeliner? What is an eyeshadow? So it kind of like just went from a thought to just like, okay, I'll just put it in the back burner. But then COVID happened and I was like, yeah, I'll release it. But then it came about.
Oh yeah. So tell me this. When did you start to write?
I started to write a few years ago. I have a lot of things that I have written about, like a little diary, little things that went down and stuff, and that kind of like was on a back burner. So I was like, one day, let me just release it. Let's see what it goes from there.
The go-go diary, when you're like a child, like, you know, oh, I like the boy today. I've seen those diaries back in college from a few women. I'm like, wow, y'all did this? Like,
yes.
I'm on the football field, I'm on the basketball court shooting ball, and, you know, I'm like, y'all writing Dear Diary. I'm like, wow, this is deep. I had no idea, like, for real, that women did it until I got to college. I'm like, wow. Because, yes. Like, I have, like, a memory, like, I talk like an elephant. I remember everything, right? So, like, I don't write stuff down. Like, you know, I move real cerebral. Like, I don't move fast, I don't move slow. I move right on time. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So people like, do this. I'm like, moving to my own speed, right? So, but see, you all writing, you know, getting stuff in, telling your diary, talking about your boy, talking about your home girls and nails and stuff. I'm like, man, that's deep stuff. You know, I just say what I got to say to a sucker at the barbershop, screw you and be done with it. You know? You know how that is. But, you know, it's funny you say that. So I guess I would say, did your diary writing give you that idea that you want to be a writer?
It's so ironic because it's like in life, it repeats itself, and it's like things that we do when we were younger, we're kind of like doing that we're older, and it's like, well, why do I like to draw and now I'm doing this? So why do I like to do my hair and now I'm doing this? So it's like it's all, you know, things that I used to do, I enjoyed doing, and it's like, okay, now I know how to do this, let me just express my creativity.
No doubt. So what advice would you give to a new writer, someone like me who does not like to write, likes to talk? So what's your advice you get to somebody like me who's a talker, who's trying to get into writing. Because when I write articles, you see they're very short to the point. I don't have like 1,000 words. And this is what happened. It's what happened. This is the stats. Done.
It takes time. Writing, it takes a while. You know, it's something you can't just throw out there or just think you're going to automatically have 300 pages. You know, it takes time. So my advice to you with that is to record yourself, you know, how your day was or whatever your genre you're trying to go into writing. Just record yourself. And then as you're, you know, typing up your stuff, you just playing and hearing it and typing to remember what you said.
For you personally, like, how do you handle writer's block? I know artists who write and rap, they have blocks and they got to either get high or drunk or listen to some music to break the block. So for you, how do you handle having a block on your writing and being your creative gene? And how do you handle that?
I take a step back. You know, you have to, sometimes when you're creative, you have to take a step back with something. If you trying to write something, you're trying to do something, it's not going to make sense. Just take a step back, go get your nails done, go get your hair done, go run in the park or something. Just take a U time, take a break.
I hear that. So what, in your opinion, are the most important elements of being a good writer? Because I know I have some ideas, but I want to hear from you because I know I'm not a good writer. I just say stuff. So what are some elements
to
being a good writer? I didn't speak what's on top of my head. I'm a freestyle king. Whatever comes to my mind, I say it. I don't plan out what I say before I say it. I just say it, you know.
Don't say that. I get a second opinion. You know, someone can always see something different in you or see your strengths. You know, don't say that. You know, I would say get a second opinion. Like if that's something that you definitely want to do, have someone review your work and, you know, get a second opinion, third opinion, fourth opinion if you want, and you'll be fine. Just everything takes time.
No doubt. So what does success mean to you?
What is what?
Success mean to you? Success.
Success is doing something that you love and doing something that you want to do. And it has to come from the heart. And you also have to be humble. Because a lot of successful people, they're not mean. They're nice, I guess. But you have to be a people person. You have to enjoy what you do.
Exactly. Now when you're a writer, do you deal with people who are know-it-alls, try to tell you how to do your job, who have no idea, who have no idea how to write? Because I know in the radio side or the business side, you get opinions from people who have no clue of how it works, but want to give you their 2 cents that you ain't asked for. But how does that work in the writing industry when you're trying to write, who don't have the creative gene that you do, or spirit that you do, but want to come in and try to kind of tell you how you should be doing what you've been doing for years and what your skill is?
I haven't experienced that, but I would say people that are like that be controlling, you gotta differentiate. You gotta let them go over there and point the finger at the wall. You gotta just keep it moving because it's not that difficult. Like, people make things difficult. You just gotta be around the right people.
No doubt. Well, on a typical day, how long do you write?
Well, I'm not saying that I'm like a ex-professional, like, you know, like I would love to get there. I have things written down. I have stories I want to say and things that I want to express, but, you know, everything is still in the making. You know, this is my first book. So it's something that's dear to me. And I'm going to be having many adventures after, many other books after. And it's something that, you know, it's just a little stepping stone.
So for you going forward here, what would you think would be the trigger for you to write your second book? Or do you have an idea already what you want that book to be?
I have an idea of how I want it to be. I want it to be more personal. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to be more, you know, saying stories and getting into that kind of like character dialect, if that makes sense.
No doubt. So do you do impressions of people? Can you do that? Can you not do impressions of people?
Yeah, I could do impressions of people. I'm not gonna do that right now, but
because I think that you know, for me, being a radio host, I know I have done characters where I have made up people who I act like and, you know, make fun of things that I've seen in my life experiences. So, you know, I think there's always fun when you can take people who you know and kind of remix them into a character and write about them or use them on the radio as you know, to make a little segment about it. You know, I think that's fun, you know, because, you know, I have a way of impersonating people. I was like a class clown back when I was, you know, in high school, mm-hmm. you know, so they, people are shocked I'm doing what I'm doing there. I was a class clown. Like, uh-huh. Look, if I was the bootleg man in the class clown, you knew I had summer up my sleeve.
So, you had the airheads and the lollipops and on sale for like 5 cents.
I would hustle, man. I had the CD, the DVDs.
Oh, God.
I had all that. I had the clothes, the shoes.
Oh, wow.
I had a Cadillac Catera. My trunk was filled with all my goods for sale. Uh-huh. So that's how I hit it that way. So, Juicy, mm-hmm. how can your readers keep up with you on social media and get that book of yours so they can help you, help a Black author, help a Black sister up in the New York area?
Hey, well, how you can help me, follow my Instagram, which is juicy_the_published_author. How you can support my book is going to Amazon and typing in Wait, How Do I, The Beginner's Guide to Makeup by Juicy. As soon as you type it in there, I am right there. Juicy, the creative mogul.
No doubt. Well, Juicy, thank you for your time, man, Juicy. I know we overcame technology. We got it done because, you know, technology is funny. It always messes with you. We need not to. So
That's a double intervening, but, you know, God is here, so.
No doubt. Well, thank you for your time, Juicy. We'll do this again real soon, and you be safe up there in New York, and I hope you are staying dry and warm up there in the city.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Bossman. I appreciate you giving me this opportunity, and thank you for allowing me to be on your show.
No doubt. For the Juicy, the creative mogul here on the Bossman Show. Get her book today on Amazon and follow her on the IG. She told you what it was. Follow today.